We should have Googled shit.
Yeah.
Okay, all right, come on with it. How I look? Let me know when you start recording.
Sweating.
My skin just oily, bro.
Do like that. That's how, yeah.
Oh, that, and then that's the shit I put in my hair.
Oh. Wait, moisturize, huh? Alright.
I look good?
Yeah.
Oh, you just saying that, bro.
Yeah, man, we got Rockstar Drip right here, man. What's going on?
Everything. You know me.
Man, what, like, first off, where you from?
Outer space.
Outer space?
Yeah, from Cosmos.
Oh, man.
Somewhere unknown.
But like, how old you is, man?
I'm 25.
25?
25. But really, I'm 25 on this earth. I really know I'm like 10,000 though. I'm like 10,000.
You want 25 though for real?
No.
Damn, Drew.
You know what I'm saying? I'm already living. Bossed up. Know what I want to do, how I want to do it.
All right, what made you start? Can I see you into the music? What made you start doing music?
Like, we didn't really know me in high school, but you know how like I played football, so we might be on a bus and everybody hit a freestyle, or you ride your homeboys and hit a freestyle. Like,
what football team you went to? You played for?
The Wildcats, Marine, I believe, Black and Gold.
Oh, and go out to Georgia.
Yeah. So you know how when it's your turn to hop on a big, like, and I knew you always like slide a little extra better than everybody. Everybody used to get hyped. It got to the point where folks used to start playing beats around me, wanting to hear me rap. And on top of that, I mean, who don't got a dream to be performing in front of 10,000 people with a mic in their hand, going crazy? And really, I'm just using my God-given talent, bro.
Alright, who you get your inspiration from? Like, who you think you like? I ain't gonna say flow, but like, who do you get inspired by?
God. What do you mean?
So if somebody had to tell you, like, okay, this you remind me of, who do you get the most?
I get so many, like, but I feel like, you know, Michael Jackson, Bob Marley, Nipsey Hussle, Rick Ross, Lil Wayne, Eminem, Future, Drake, and every other hot artist that you know that you like, if they all combined together and had a baby, it'd be me.
What's your, okay, name me three things you got to have in the studio.
First thing, I gotta have God with me. Second, I just gotta have a vibe. Like, the energy gotta be there. My mind gotta be there. Like, cause if I ain't there, it ain't gonna be like there. But and like whoever recorded me, the energy gotta be right. And I ain't gonna lie, lately I've been taking that teleport to the studio. I sent me my little pint of that teleport.
Yeah.
And go to walk.
Explain to me your creative process.
It's so many different ways. Like, I got producers that can send me beats all day.
Mm-hmm.
And so I might ride around all day, listen to a couple beats. And then when I get in the studio, I kind of might already have a hook, or might even been and got in my pen a little bit. But a lot of times I just go in there and check my email, bro. And whichever beat just resonate with me while I'm on the computer, I just hop to my engineer, I pull it up, and that's what we on.
Yeah. Okay.
But life's great. I mean, shop open.
And I heard in your music, like, you don't smoke anymore. Like, I know back then, like, in your other videos, like, you was like, you feel me? Burn. Go down, like,
mm-hmm.
What happened to that?
Well, you know, I'm very big on energy. So I recently found out, well, not recently, but about a year ago, I had found out that marijuana actually lowers your vibration. and I like to be very high vibrational, so I can't have anything lowering my vibration. But on top of that, I had a situation where I had to go away for some time, and to be honest, when I was in that place, all I could think about was marijuana, like smoking. It got so bad, I was like smoking on my fingers while I'm in there. And I really did ask God, I'm like, hey, can you get me out this weed? And this was before I went in, like, can you get me out the weed? Because it was consuming my life. Like, I was having to smoke before I go to a meeting, smoke before I ate, smoke before I hung out with anybody. Like, come on, like, I mean, bro, you know the old me. After this meal, I'd had a bet with him already. But I just feel like sometimes in life, to excel, you got to give up something that's consuming your life. And really, when I had got out, bro, I tried to smoke because that's all I wanted to do. Like, that was first. As soon as I got to the crib, I knew I had some there. I'm like, bro, I need to roll it up. Like, and when I hit it, it just felt funny, bro. Yeah. And then every time after that I tried to, my body just didn't really like accept it. So I'm just listening to my body. Not even when I smell it. Like, I don't know nobody who smoked, but that's just not what I'm on no more.
Yeah. Like, what's your, how you explain how you grew up?
It was, some people would, like, think I maybe had, like I'm a spoon-fed dude, because my dad had a restaurant, but the restaurant was on the south side, bro, right, in the heart of the trenches. So I seen a little bit of everything, heard a little bit of everything, experienced a little bit of everything. You know, on top of that, like, even in the schools, I was able to hang out with both sides, like all different cultures. So, I mean, I was just able to get a lot of knowledge from a lot of people and, you know, just learn from my mistakes, make mistakes, and just keep living. Thank God that I wasn't raised in, like, no poor home. Like, school time, like, pops take me to the mall, spending $1,000. I wasn't playing, but even then, like, when I was a kid, I was working. I was at Andy's. I had my own money. If I knew if I wouldn't come to Andy's, I wasn't finna get no money. My allowance is dead. On the top of it, the whole industry finna be off. So as a kid, bro, I was always working. Anybody tell you that? As a kid until now, I always been working, so.
Yeah. What made you, okay. How would you describe your style?
Unorthodox. Like the wave, the tsunami. You know, people say, well, I moonwalk on the beat like Michael. Like, I can come like this or that. I can be real poetic one day. Then the next day, I'm a whole rock star. I go play Bill Carter. Or, hey, you know, I might have a. Might have a shouty who I want to wow. I might go in there and make a song like it's enough.
How do you deal with haters and trolls on the internet?
Embrace it. I love it. If you hang on me, thank you. I really appreciate it. To be honest,
real deal, real spill. You know, I'm making you a good meal. We are all just spirits having a human experience. Very great Sunday. I hope everyone goes into this week focused with a clear mind, with no stress. Your breakthrough season is here. I say that to say, when you are rising, when you are elevating, you are going to attract a lot of good people. You're also going to attract a lot of negative energy. And someone's negative might be a positive, like, so don't really just judge off the back, but if it's not in alignment, then it's not in alignment. So just because you're positive don't mean everybody else is gonna, like, reciprocate that energy.
Some people might be a leech, an energy sucker that's gonna try to bring you down. So just say, just say that, and we good over here, baby.
Ooh, a little hot at first. She's trying to burn me. I'm gonna boil him.
Look. Okay, all right. And look, hey, I need my hands too, though. So I need my hands too. Oh, okay.
Yeah, so which one? What give me my total? Yeah, of course. What will be my total? If I get the... Okay, so this one in my hands? Okay. And how what are these at?
Okay.
What a manicure at, too?
Manicure?
Yeah, so both.
Buddy.
All right.
Buddy.
Okay, cool. That'll work. See, they're my friend. She get me right every time. And where are you from again? Where are you from? What city are you from? Where were you born? Like your birthplace?
Okay.
She don't even know what I said. It's okay. but this is my friend. It's the place I come to. It's crazy. The other place we had went to, what they gave me a 20-minute wait.
Yeah.
And I don't even go there tripping.
Tripping.
Going against my rules.
Oh, this is where you always go at?
Yeah.
All the time.
Yeah. You see, I come here, they give me.
Which one they say you wine at?
I think they can wine here. What one we just at? They do wine.
Yeah.
And Nails by Christy, right?
They do? Mm-hmm. Thank you.
She thought I said water. I said, where you from? It's all right, though. But I imagine that. That got to be kind of hard, though. Like, could you imagine going to like Japan or something and then like they don't really know what you're saying? And you know, you gotta work somewhere.
I gotta have a friend that knows.
Like a translator?
Yeah.
Nah. Hey, what's the name of the city you told me to visit again?
Ho Chi Minh.
Okay. Bet.
Where did you go?
No, I didn't go yet.
You go to China?
No, I didn't go yet. I didn't go.
Playing, he playing, doing all that playing.
I'm stacking up my funds. Yeah, I've been vlogging all day.
I wanna buy the microphone like that too.
The microphone? For what? What you gonna do with it?
YouTube.
For real? Cause you kind of funny, ain't you? You funny. I know you funny.
I probably make some money.
You know, hey, do it. I got this from Amazon.
Huh?
I say Amazon. I got it from Amazon.
But I'm looking for a good one.
This is a good one. The battery, battery lasts like 4 or 5 hours, and
how many hours?
Like 5 hours.
5 hours.
Yeah, and it got good.
I have a one that lasts all day.
A day?
Oh. Like 10 hours.
Oh, okay. Yeah, mine don't last that long.
You like that?
So Sundays are really for self care for me. I come see my girl Diamond. Here at Deluxe Nails and Spa, you know, but also Georgia, this is where I come to. I ain't knocking nowhere else, but it's a spot to take good care of me. We're just chilling today, me and Guap just shot like 3 videos, so I had to come in on just get my feet taken care of. So Guap, what's your mood today?
What's my mood today? Mm-hmm. Hey, okay, I been with drip, man. I been with drip, man. We just enjoying life, really.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Something different. You know what I'm saying?
So what is energy to you?
What is energy to me? Energy is like your mood, right? Like.
Let me see. Yeah, so you know. Okay. Energy is what?
Energy like. My mood, like, well, like, how can I say it? Like, my energy, like, you know, you have good energy, bad energy, you know. But I really like having good energy because I like energy is like, I'm gonna say
it's everything,
but I'm trying to, it's a word I'm trying to think of, I can't really think of like that. You get what I'm saying? Like,
so, is it a way that you, what's the way that you deal with?
Low vibration, high vibration.
All right, now, Dow, don't fall. Now, I see you. That baby like it getting a little heavy, Dow. What's the way that you deal with bad energy? Like, let's say, like, you, okay, we're going to put it in normal terms. Like, okay, let's say you got the shit, right? And you call her, and you have a good day.
A good day.
And then you call her, like, you on some, like, just checking on, like, spreading love, like,
yeah.
Although, you know,
you call with good intentions.
Good intentions. And she just, attention. And she go throw it off, like, like what you gonna do? Are you hanging up? You trying to talk it out? Like what you gonna do?
I'ma tell her. I'ma be straight up. Like I try to, you know, try to give good energy. You know, good vibes. But if I see it ain't on that, then hey, I gotta go. I gotta. You feel me?
Like this ain't that.
I'm gonna try to spread my positive energy. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I'm gonna try to spread my positive energy.
Yeah.
And to you, you get what I'm saying? But if you're not on that, then
you ain't gonna be a receiver.
Yeah, because low vibration. What you say?
Low vibration. Repels and receives low vibration.
So you feel me? You know, if talk to me when you good. You
talk to me when you get back balance.
Talk to me when you get back balance.
Cause maybe you need to go meditate or go outside for a walk.
You feel me?
Cause you tripping.
Read.
Do something.
You want to be on the internet all day.
That would mess you up.
That would mess you up. You want to be on that phone all day. You looking at all this. Now you depressed. You know what I'm saying?
Do you know the first 2 hours, well, when you wake up, you're not supposed to check your phone?
Yeah. Real though.
Or especially not scroll on Instagram.
Yeah.
It's mentally unhealthy.
It's mentally unhealthy?
Mm-hmm.
You're right.
Like my first 2 hours. My first 2 hours of the day, my first 2 hours of the day, I ain't really talking to nobody.
You ain't?
Talking to nobody. No, that's my time for me.
So what you do? What time you wake up?
It varies.
What time you wake up in the morning?
It varies. Some, like, I be on like some 4:35 a.m. and I hit the gym.
I'm saying like,
hold on. I've been trying to get you on that gym for I don't know how long, but.
But I've been running though. I've been running that track. I gotta go to the track. What you trying to do today?
I ain't working out today.
You got the feet dead.
No, it ain't even that.
You got the feet dead.
Today's like a rest day for me.
Yeah.
Hey, see, they don't know about the hot wet. Get the hot wet on there. Ooh, that hot wet gonna get you right.
Yeah.
So every 2 weeks, I'm coming to Deluxe Nails and Spa, coming to see Diamond every 2 weeks. But, I mean, we can go tomorrow morning, though.
Tomorrow morning? Yeah. So you said, all right. So what if you wake up at 10, you ain't get on your phone? 2 hours.
I mean, unless it's like business, unless I gotta call somebody, but as far as me, I'm not scrolling on social media.
Yeah.
First of all, unless like, you know, I'm gonna give y'all a cheat code. Start having your, ooh, I know he happy. Start having your.
That's his friend.
Can't be. Well, it probably is, cause he went home or nothing. You supposed to hold something like that. You gotta hold that hand.
Something like that,
boy. Hold that hand.
Yeah.
You with me.
Yeah.
You with me today.
Yeah,
I'm letting it be known.
No cap.
We got a little sidetrack, but yeah. I'm giving anybody who's doing content curation, you know, they got apps and stuff. Now, even at the Instagram got a setting where you can like automatically have your post like on a set timer, so make posts in advance, so that way like you ain't really gotta try to make a video edit when you already it's Monday, but you already got post lined up for Tuesday, Wednesday, because you
for real?
You know that?
Nah.
You can already like have it to what you and you got to do, and it's going to post
for you.
You can automatically make it with caption. You can schedule it.
I ain't know that. Mm-hmm. That's hard. I ain't know that.
Mm-hmm. Hey, you learn something new every day.
Yeah. I ain't know that.
What's, I got a question for you. What's one obstacle that you faced last week, and how did you overcome it?
Last week? What happened last week? What happened last week? How did I overcome it?
Mm-hmm.
I ain't gonna lie. I had 2 video shoots last week.
Mm-hmm.
But it was in Tilton.
Mm-hmm. You could have put that towel on now.
Ooh. Yeah. I had 2 videos last week.
Mm-hmm.
They both in Tilton, mm-hmm. right?
Did you like?
But the thing is,
did you plan that to be in Tilton, or it just happened like that?
Nah, I planned on one being in Tilton.
Yeah.
You feel me? Uh-huh. Okay. I planned on one being in Tilton.
Mm-hmm. Then,
so when I had one plan on Tilton. So when I was there shooting one video, dude asked me, you feel me?
Like, you want to get one in?
I was like, you feel me? I gave him my price. I wasn't finna go down on my price. You feel me? Like, all right, drop the deposit down on me. I usually don't do that, though, Kai. You feel me? I don't do it on spot days. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Because, like, you already.
I want to be playing. I want to be
prepared.
Prepared. Yeah. For, you feel me? Because. But so happened, the dude only did most enough talk, so you feel me? I had some battery left, you feel me, for the second video, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Yeah, we got through it, you know. Mm-hmm. One of my lights had broke, too.
Ooh, so how you, after that broke, like you still shot? I still shot it.
It
still came out straight?
Yeah.
How your light broke? It just went out? It dropped?
Not having it properly equipped in the truck.
Oh.
You know, something fell on it, then it had broke the back of it, you know. Yeah,
that's crazy.
But you gotta keep that slow.
Yeah.
PPP. What it called? PPPP, not PPP.
What?
You know what I'm saying?
What I mean?
Poor performance. No, you got to say prepare.
Yeah, do you know it? Yeah.
What it is?
You tell me. You said it.
Poor performance.
Oh yeah. Poor you go to the PPPP.
Poor performance prevents. I forgot. Performance prevents. You know what I mean, though. Yeah, I know what I mean. You know, somebody told me the other day. Appointments.
You so faded,
man. What he said?
I don't know.
He came to the shop the other day.
He said appointments what?
Mike.
He said appointments what?
Appointment disappoint. Oh no, appointments avoid disappointments.
Fast. Oh, okay. Yeah. Did you know what he meant by that?
Disappointments, yeah.
Fact, cause basically, like when you already have it set up,
yeah,
it's already set in stone.
Facts.
Now somebody cancel on you already got your deposit.
Yeah.
So you cancel on me, I'm paid.
I'm paid still.
Now
I don't want nobody to do it. I need their back end.
Make sure to like and subscribe. Lots more content on the way. More vlogs. More music. Stay tuned, and yes, I'm a Virgo.